स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू।
एक्सरसाइज नंबर 16। सर, ड्यूरिंग दिस डिबेट इट वॉज इंटरेस्टिंग एंड एजुकेटिव टू लिसन टू आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एक्सपर्ट। आई मस्ट से डेट इट सीम्स टू मी डेट द क्वेश्चन एट इशू इज नॉट मियरली अलीगल or a constitutional one. The constitutional amendments which we have introduced contain and reflect the urges of our people. For some time, there has been a deliberate inflation of fears which to me seems to be unreal. A controversy has been generated as regards the supremacy of Parliament against the supremacy of the Constitution, as if these two were distinct concepts, mutually exclusive and even perhaps opposite. Those who describe the issue in this manner conveniently forget that our Constitution was drafted on the fundamental assumption that our people have firm faith in the principles of democracy. This faith in our people reflects in our constitution. Several honorable members have spoken of the confrontation between Parliament and the judiciary. There need not be a confrontation, and I think that to create an atmosphere of confrontation does not do us much good. I do not think that there is any real confrontation, either because each institution has its assigned place and role. We all know that there can be no third chamber and that no constitution can be frozen into a static position. What do we see when we look at the world around us? It would not take us long to discover that many an institution has collapsed. Many a constitution has been scrapped because it ceased to be an effective instrument for orderly change. That our constitution and our democratic institutions have survived when all around us there is a climate of tension and violence is a tribute to the faith of our people in democratic ideals and also to the flexibility and responsiveness of our constitution and our political institutions to the urges of our people. While introducing this bill, my colleague spoke of the arguments of those opposed this bill as being based on fear and nervousness. I should like to dispel the fear and nervousness in the minds of our minorities in so far as their rights are concerned. I believe that protection to them can be guaranteed only by this parliament. Mere constitutional devices cannot give guarantee. History is full of example of constitution being overthrown or frustrated. Therefore, a wider and deeper democracy is a more durable guarantee of the rights of our minorities. My endeavor has not been to defeat parties, but to educate the public and strengthen the people so that they themselves will not permit any curtailment of their rights. The protection of the rights of the minorities can be ensured only when the majority itself is convinced that its well-being and progress is linked with a sense of security amongst the minority communities. In the ultimate analysis, it is only a sensitive and strong public opinion which can give real protection to the minorities. The major premise of democracy is the will of the people as expressed through parliament. As my honorable friend said in his excellent speech, if our democracy had gone violent and had become an instrument of oppression, it would have failed and something else would have taken its place. If such anarchy were to take place in our country, holding the constitution against the flood waters of right reaction or of violent revolution would not divert the tide. There is an unending attempt by wasted interest to divide the people and to mislead the minorities. I am confident that our people are committed to democracy. They understand and respond to the need for a secular approach, the need for change within a democratic framework, and the need to prevent narrow-visted interests from obstructing the processes of changes. We all know that change is a fact of life, whether we like it or not. We all know that the clever arguments cannot bind us to the past. If you look at the circumstances of life as it is in India, I see no reason in a denial of radical change. Whatever is made rigid ceases to be living and organic, and many becomes less and less reflective of the needs of a vital and dynamic people. So, what are the choices before us? Can we adhere to the status quo? There is a crisis in the social order, not only in India, but in every country of the world. And the choice in every country is whether changes can come about peacefully or whether they must be driven to violent means. I heard several members from the opposition saying that I was twisting the meaning. I think all those who have read newspapers in the past few months and all those who have followed the election campaigns know there where the twisting has taken place, how everything we have said has been twisted and misconstrued. We believe in the commitment and we shall continue to believe in it. I think in today's world, this is a word which has great significance for the future. Thank you.